it right, there are two types of raster scan, okay, and vector scan. You see, it goes here and comes back here, it can turn here only. There are various techniques, okay, this is a beam off, beam on. So you cannot switch on and switch off, beam blankers will work on that, okay. So this is a very complicated system, so that you can write the structures. So you have the circles and you are overlapping the circles, the spots, such that you write, expose. So there's a very tricky thing, how best you can overlap the circles, otherwise edges will be very rough. It will be like this. So you have to do all these things, a lot of, you know, art as well as you have to work on these things. And you can write like this also, okay, this rectangular spot, all can be manipulated. And little bit of mathematics I have to say here, don't worry, because you have to resolution, current and dose. It's very, very important, because the dose is a charge. You have electron beam that has a charge, and you have to have this one microcoulomb per centimeter square, and current parallelly, and the time of exposure, okay, okay, area, what is the, you know, 1.6 nanometers clock frequency, highest frequency whatever you can achieve, you know, stage moves, okay, a faster write time, all this you have to you know, compromise on various things. And vibration isolation, very, very important. So you have to optimize for each of these photoresist, whatever, anything you change, you have to optimize. So you have set up and you have optimized, you can use the same thing. So any little bit change, you have to optimize mathematically. The reason is, electron is a charged particle. It will cause other things as well, okay? So scientifically, what other things it can do? Up to what time I can speak? Till one. Oh, okay, no problem. Is it too much? Is it too much? Are you following it? But tell me if you are feeling sleepy, I'll stop there itself. Okay, so this is how it is done. Stage moves, current. So all you have to play around. Okay, so this training will be given by those people, those who supply. Okay, we. And there also they, in a way they cheat us. They don't tell you everything. They hide all information because they want money. They will see that, okay, I don't know how to do this one. Okay, without paisa. Okay, they will give. They will come all the way. So engineer will come. They will charge like anything. So that's why you have to depend so much on them. That's why I always encourage the youngsters, start your own things. Okay. Interact with the scientists, you know, you can start your own business, build up. I think I saw, you know, your college is encouraging that kind of things, okay. Don't wait for somebody to give the job all the time. You may suffer for some time, some years, maybe 1 year, 2 years, 5 years. I think one day you will come out with your own, you know, product or something where country can benefit, okay. This we have to develop. Then only we can achieve. Otherwise, we just keep on talking like this and we will not be able to do anything with so much of talents, okay. You are all, you know, highly talented, but the country is not able to provide the right platform to bring out your talent into something which, you know, which will have a social impact, okay. Think that way, okay. So if out of this, if one person does it, I will be very happy to see in future, okay. So this is how it is done, and you see, I think whether I have put it there, huh? 1 minute. So this is what the resolution place. Okay? How best you can control resolution is the how minimum feature you can achieve. That's the actual nano. I can achieve 50. See, best we have achieved in IASC is around 20 nanometer structure working. Okay? So other countries have achieved 5 nanometer, 10 nanometer. Very, you know, simply they are doing it. So another important thing is this 10 nanometers, can you repeat it? That is very important. Maybe once I can do it. Scientifically, we don't accept it. Can you repeat it with same conditions? Then only it is possible. So these are all the limitations you have to try, you know, understand. Now, low throughput is all known. The limitations I think I already explained. Long exposure time leaves the user impatient because writing 10 transistors will take hours together, not worth. And turnaround time for reworking, redesign, everything is complicated. Okay, not like a, see, in an optical lithography, your mask, if your mask is right, so you make some structure, suppose the structure is not working, you are not losing much because the mask is ready, again put it and you can repeat it. Here it is, it doesn't work like that. Again you have to start from the scratch. So these are the limitations with this e-beam lithography, though it is possible to make nanostructures. This is where the bottleneck is. Okay, that's what the challenge is. How best, because our mindset is used to the well-established microfabrication. Silicon wafer, we know the process is done. Is it possible to do the same thing with this? That's what the scientists all over the world working, whether silicon technology can be extended to do the same thing. Or this, whether this electron beam lithography can be extended similar to well-established silicon wafer fabrication process. Okay? Now, there are varieties of photoresist. I'm not talking, because this is a business again. You can go to any company, they always make. See, it's all, I told you, most of you, them are interdisciplinary. Material scientists, they keep on making varieties of photoresist. They keep on telling the sensitivity is very good, this thing, that thing. So you buy and verify all these things. Or you yourself can come out with interesting photoresist material and market it. Okay? There are all possibilities. So this is a well-established photoresist, PMMA, polymethyl methacrylate, JAP, this one, HSQ, various types of there. And you can see this one in the website also. If you go to the companies, they will give all these things. Okay? Then, this is about polymethyl methacrylate. Here, the proximity correction is very important. Every time you need to do this one, this is a Monte Carlo simulation. Don't worry about here. The Gaussian one exponential function. Why it is required here is, I told electron is a particle, it has a charge. When high energy electron beam hits the material, it is a different phenomena compared to an optical beam. Optical beam is a light photon energy, it has only energy, no mass, no charge. Okay? So when electron hits the material like this, there are various things. It can, the optical that will hit, will be absorbed only on the surface, but electron can go inside the material. A lot of differences. Okay? This is very important because the dose and energy, current, everything you have to control, because the high energy electron beam, see here, 30 kV electron beam, here also same, through 60 nanometer PMMA on silicon, you can see this is silicon and this is a PMMA, okay, layer. I hope you can imagine this simulation. Okay, this is a cross section, this is silicon, this is photoresist. Okay, so this photoresist is around 60 nanometer, okay, 60 nanometer thick layer, thin layer, okay, not thick, very thin. Can you imagine 60 nanometer? 1 nanometer is 10 to the power minus 9. Okay? So, if you look at the simulation, 30 kV, you see there are no backscattered electrons, minimum. These electrons will go inside, hit the atoms in the silicon, they may generate secondary electrons. These electrons will come back and they create issues here. Okay? So, if I have a single transistor different, if I have multiple transistors, these electrons will create the exposure, again re-exposure from the bottom. When I develop it, I think I will not get the structure what I am wanted. So same with a gold, okay, you see 60 nanometer PMMA and I have a 50 nanometer gold, okay, on this is silicon PMMA and 50 nanometer gold, the interaction of electron beam is different. You look at this, the cluster of secondary electrons are coming, my structure is gone. So this one, you have to optimize for each material. You have to do simulate. Sometimes you have to repeat the experiment 10 times and you have to target. Okay? This is very, very critical. Okay? Electron solid scattering simulated using casino. Okay? I think you all enjoy simulations. Is it correct? Huh? Okay, so see, You can enjoy with this one also, but don't just play with the computers and end up there only, but try to realize, you know, experimentally. Then only it is worth doing, okay? So, this is how you have to optimize the dose. Then, look at the way dose modification write this instrument. Same thing we did an experiment and imaged it, okay? This is a, okay, picture of scattering simulation, features of whole pattern, the smallest elements apply individual appropriate dose. You see, look at the same thing simulated, and we have taken the image of this one. What we tried to do is we wrote, you know, lines like this, okay, the same procedure we followed, and look at the actual images. This is an optical grating we used to, first we fabricated long back, around 10 years back now. You see the lines here. This is around 50 nanometers, okay, with the first structure, the simulation first I showed. The second with the gold, you could look at the structure here, the lines are not straight, they spread. Same experiment, okay, same simulation, we compared with the experiment, we are not able to get it, gone. Okay, so this are now, I cross-checked with this one with a light experiment, and that is working. Okay, but with the same thing, I am not able to get this diffraction pattern. So this is how you have to do simulation, experiment, cross-check. Okay, this is how you have to develop your experiment. Okay, this is how it is done. The same thing, you see, the writing area, this is a very small area, the dose variation will come. You cannot write large area using this electron beam lithography because of various other control parameters are playing crucial role over there, okay? So, like that, you can do a lot of, you know, other structures, like the optical lithography, you can do transistor, this thing, you can do various structures, that's called NEMS, nano electromechanical systems. This is a photonic crystal, the cantilever, everything can be done, and like this, you can make transistors, okay, and rods, and some of these structures are done in our. So here, any course on optic or photonics or electronics, communications, fiber optic communications? Fiber, okay. Maybe I think some of the words you are not familiar with, okay. If anything you don't understand, you are free to ask, okay. Okay. So this comes to us, you know, just like that. Okay, this is, you know, like that. You can do varieties of structures. Okay, not only, you know, electronics, you can do other types of sensors. And okay, this is you know, various type of, this is again a transistor, one of our students, they have done it, okay. This is the parameters they are talking about, don't worry about. And you see, these are the, you know, these are all in nanoscale, okay. In nanoscale, you can play around, okay. So ultimately, what is the use of this? Okay, there is, you know, application for everything. So you don't do just like something and okay, this I can do, but always target with some application, you will get something. You know, this is the one, this is not done by me or this thing, not in India. This is one of my friends in US. He is a very good, you know, electron beam lithography person who made it. With his permission, I am using this one. He says, this is a creature kind of thing. By applying voltage, he can make them to move back and forth. Okay. This is a separated structure on a silicon. He made the process there. I don't know how he did it, he didn't tell me anything, but he says it can be used as a sensor somewhere. I don't know, maybe bacterial sensor or something maybe, and he says it can move, it can control everything, okay. This is how you can do. See, this is maybe around 100 nanometer structure. You imagine this leg may be around 10 nanometer, I don't know, okay, the details he didn't give, okay. So this is all through electron beam lithography, okay. So. This is one way. Then another one is focused ion beam. Instead of the same process can be done using, instead of this one electron, you can use focused. You know that ions are neutral. You know that ions are neutral atoms. You can use instead of electron beam, you can do the same thing with focused ion beam. But again, there are limitations, okay. So this is a focused ion beam system, okay. This is how it is done. Always remember, whichever I showed on electron beam lithography, you know that SEM, scanning electron microscopy, That is simultaneously done. Okay, we don't do as SEM separately. When you are writing in electron beam lithography, the secondary electrons, we use it for imaging. All the structure which I show on an electron beam lithography is a SEM itself, scanning electron microscope. Understand, okay? So keep this all in mind. That's very important. You know, the resolution of electron microscope is around 10 nanometer. I can see 10 nanometer structures even below, okay? That is very, very important. That's how the nanotechnology is coming up. You are able to see what you are doing at nanoscale. So again, focus ion beam, I'm not going to the details of this one. Okay, there are various problems. The most fundamental difference between FIB, focused ion beam, electron beam is as SEM, STM, EBIT, the use of ions instead of electrons and has major consequences for interactions that occur at the sample surface. Again, ions interact differently with the materials. Electrons will interact differently. Photons interact differently. So this is a basic physics and chemistry we must know. And ions are larger than electrons, another problem, okay? Ions are larger than electrons, dimension-wise, because it's an atom, okay? So this is also available. People are using it for various type of structures. I'm not going to the details. This is a process that is taking place over there. Then we can do varieties of structures like this, okay? Then FIB is often used in semiconductor industry for to patch or modify the existing, this thing. So there are various applications. Even FIB can be used for removing some of the materials on the silicon, which is done through electron beam lithography or optical beam. So these are the different types of processes you can use it for. So not only for lithography, okay? IC of gallium, okay, don't worry about all these things. Doping of semiconductor is also used for markless, maskless, this thing. And another one is AFM lithography, which I showed in the beginning. You can, okay, this is the AFM used for making surface analysis at high resolution of 5 nanometers, even below. Now, this is loaded with certain force. When it scans on the surface, it will move up and down depending upon the surface roughness. Now, if I fully press it on the photo, if I instead of this is the roughness. Now I take this one silicon wafer or some substrate, then I coat a photoresist. Instead of tapping mode, I put a load on it, and if I pull it down, it makes a scratch at nanoscale. That's also another technique people are using it. But if you look at this one, this is as good as plowing. You see, this is the reference. You apply the load and pull it, it makes a scratch over there. So people used to do the plowing for ages. Maybe that has gone to now, nanoscale, okay? So it is my photo only, don't worry. Then, okay, this is the tip, okay, you can make it also. And you can, but there are limitations, okay? You see the roughness here. Okay, the problem is when you pull it, the debris will come. Okay, it is pulling the material, it will put it at the end. And the sides will not be smooth at the nanoscale. They are rough, okay? But at some situations, people use it, okay? Then bottom-up method. Now, all this, I talked about the electron beam lithography, focused ion beam, X-ray, optical lithography, all can be used. But every lithography has limitations in terms of, okay, diffraction and mass scale, production and other physical chemical interactions with the material, okay, because of the source, okay, maybe ion or electron beam, and the existing technology. I think you have a feel for it now. Another method is called the bottom-up approaches, where other disciplines also working together. This is what I talked about for nanoelectronics and other things. Now, this is called a bottom-up approach. It's a self-assembly. People, green synthesis, chemical methods. These are all called bottom-up approaches. Now, that is, well-established. People are using various chemical processes, techniques to make nanoparticles. They may not be, planar structures, but they are particles. not necessary. But these particles can be extracted to the planar structures on silicon to do other things. That's how I think in a nutshell I can explain. Okay, there are various things. Okay, sol gel method, PECVD, LPCVD. Okay, plasma enhanced chemical vapor deposition, low pressure. Okay, this one chemical vapor. This one PLD. Laser, pulse laser deposition, hydrothermal method, or various other chemical methods. So I think I have been working on some of these things also. So giving nanostructures, but not necessarily wafer fabrication type of process there, okay? And self-assembly, I think you can see, I told you the bottom-up approaches, you can, even you can make structures in even using kitchen, tools like that. So this is how backbone, you have some structure and it is pulled up like that, and you can expose, do various things. And this is one of the our work only. We used this one nanosphere lithography, where we got similar structures, okay, at nanoscale. This is around nanometer polystyrene spheres we had, and again sputtering, removing all these things. And this is a AFM image. This is a nano triangle we called, I think people accepted, you see triangle, various type of structures. This all chemical procedure process we are making, and don't worry about all these things. Ultimately, what we wanted to see is a application. So this nanostructure has given us an important application that's called fluorescence enhancement. Fluorescence enhancement. You know that in biology, the first technique they use to see anything is a fluorescence, fluorescence imaging. Okay. Confocal microscope, fluorescence microscope, this. I think those who have biology background, they understand. So some of the biomolecules are weak fluorescence. That means their fluorescence intensity is low, such that you cannot image it. So we came out with some, this kind of nanostructures, and you put these biomaterials on these nanostructures, we saw the fluorescence enhancement. Okay? So some people are very excited to take this one where there is a weak fluorescing biomolecules. That's how the applications you have to find it. And this is again a nanostructure, okay? Like this is again our one of our works only. This is again a sol gel method, hydrothermal method. We didn't do anything. Took some zinc, okay, substrate, put some chemical hydrothermal method. Water is put together and hydrogen peroxide. Just a Teflon chamber, very small, like a teacup size, and put it in an oven for 10 hours. Next day we came, we saw that is cooked into a nanostructure, okay? But we couldn't see. We went into the SEM and we saw that structures are forming, and we are using it for various other applications in the nano composites and in bio applications. We are using these zinc oxide nanostructures. I think some publications are already there, okay? The interesting thing is, you look at the tip, okay? It's highly charged. So we had varieties of structure. This is a hexagonal structure. You see, very beautiful structure this is, okay? And we are trying to make it all vertical. Now they are scattered, or trying to pull single one and put it and use it. It's a highly useful in some of the things, saw devices, and some of the transistors we are trying to explore. And even flat structures are also there. I think I don't have all those things, okay? Growth parameters are there, okay? So this is just a simple chemical method. You do anything, a small oven, chamber, some chemical, put it there, some structure will come, okay? This is how nano works, but I tell you, you have to think how best I can exploit it, okay? Nano may be there everywhere. If you take something here and go put it on a microscope, you see some nanostructures, okay? So that's how it goes. And a lot of opportunities for nano, basic research, the technology development, okay, new frontier opening areas, product development, and all. See, we have to see how best we can make use of, okay? And government is funding all the time. Now government is telling, why can't you go to industries? Who will bell the cat? That is the question. So in India, we never did this kind of research. We have no connection between industry and the research and the government. So that's a big issue. But it's the right time that we have to think in that way, whether we can do a lot of things, you know, high impact research, commercial potential, industrial partnership, major opportunities. Why I'm telling, because you all, you know, will be in the job market. All final year students, third year, all in 1 or 2 years, you will be in the, you know, job market. You will go into the sea of, you know, people looking for this thing, that thing. Okay, focus. I think you have a very good opportunity in this direction as well. And maybe what India can do is still a question mark. Question front end technology, back end technology, and system development, bottom up. See what is where. Okay, I think we are very good in back end technology. We all will do back side only. That means that's the corruption. Okay, that's where. It's a very pity thing to say. Everywhere it is there. Okay, so that back end technology has to go, and we have to go for electronic back end technology where we can do something. Okay, so this I keep it open for you all. And then I think I will summarize here what I have talked about. Okay, I think I'm able to give some idea into nanotechnology and what are the challenges. Hope, I think I'm able to put you some ideas into your mind. I'm open to questions, okay? Any questions? I think everybody is hungry. We are not asking questions.
Any questions?
Sir, my question is, is there any health risk from this nanomaterials?
Yeah, definitely, definitely. Because that's what I told in the beginning itself. There is no well-studied report saying that nano is hazardous, but definitely it is hazardous, no doubt about it, because these nanoparticles can enter your body from anywhere, okay, because the holes near your hair can take the nanoparticles inside. See, there are issues like this, like nano is being used for drug delivery. We don't know the long-term effect of these nanoparticles, because one of our colleagues is working on cancer. He wants to use these nanoparticles to carry the drugs to the point of care method. They don't know what is going to happen after 2 years, 3 years. So it's a study that has to take place, maybe 10 years or 20 years, we don't know, because this has to evolve. Because one of the examples I can give you is a laser. You all use lasers, you know the laser pointers, and very simple, okay. And lasers are dangerous to eyes. I think we never teach this laser safety in this country at all. Okay? Laser is a simple pointer. If I shine to your eye straight, you may become blind. As simple as that. Because I experienced, because when I went to first time to that country, Singapore, I was given a lab. I started a laser lab. And lasers, okay, I got, you know, that YAG laser and put it, and the students are working. There is a system, they made a beautiful laser lab and a black, you know, curtain everywhere. Okay, lot of hazards will come. Then there was a, you know, one window, small window, the laser beam was going out to the door, road, out of the. So that somebody complained that some light is coming here, because it's a pointed light. It was going to the car or somebody. Then they tracked it, and one day finally they traced it, that is coming from the lab. Then who is in charge of the lab? Me. And I was called to the Ministry of Health. Okay, where is your laser safety training certificate? I never heard in my life these certificates. I don't know. Then who allowed you to use the laser there? As a visitor, I came there, I gave a position and started the laboratory. And they were about to put me in jail, because without, I never heard this. Till today, we don't have the laser safety at all in this. This is the first warning, and you are supposed to go and attend the laser safety training for 1 month, sent to US, and I got the certification of, okay, he can use the laser. And every year I have to renew that license, like a vehicle license, whatever it is. Then I was allowed. Okay. Now I am a trained, say, laser safety. I can give laser safety training, but in this country I say, I give a talk on laser safety, people will laugh. What it is. Same way, nano also, because this laser safety is there for last 50 years, there is a standard defined by different countries, and every year they study. Say, UV laser, it may cause cancer. They cannot say on one day, it has to go for 10 years study that a person who will, see, that's how nano is also on the same line, I think maybe after few years, because not yet gone to that level, definitely it is a very dangerous, people have predicted, okay, to what level it can cause damages, that has to be assessed, okay, that data will be there. It's a good question, okay.
Thank you, sir.
Very important, that's what I showed you, any science without a sense on environment and nature has no meaning. Okay, it has to be. So because now they are studying, because computer ways, now they are facing a big problem. Never thought about it. Okay, sorry.
Sir, can you suggest some of the topics or fields for research in nanotechnology?
It's a very difficult question to answer, but still what I can say is, because you have to design the problem, based on your interest and also the infrastructure around you, okay, my suggestion is try to see, I showed some big instrumentation and all. Don't think that a research requires such a big instrumentation. You start with anything with a simple, such that you can do yourself and give us good scientific thinking into it. That is the best way. That way, okay, what is your background? What is your background? You are
working? M.Tech in digital electronics and
digital electronics. Okay. So that means you have a chance to think about some, you know, new materials for any of this process which I showed. Okay. Whether you can make a structure, which material will help to do that kind of structure. You have to plan in such a way that maybe a simple CMOS process using that one. Or you can think of something which are micro-electro, nano-electromechanical system design. Design first. Because these days, very important thing is to simulate everything. You can do a lot of things using, you know, softwares available. Then come out with the simplest process which can be taken up here or anywhere where you can collaborate. See, that is very important. Collaboration is important. You have to have an interaction with the people who are already in that. So that way, whatever we can have, we are there to help, okay? So science will come only with many people together. Otherwise, if you are doing in a, you know, close, you know, wall, you will not be able to achieve.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, in biological systems, in the cells, if we take, they produce their own organelles, right, in very accurate and perfect manner. Why can't we mimic those like principles to produce nano materials?
No, that is, I think it's already there. Biomimicking, yeah, using nano materials and nano structure is already there. People are working. Like some of this nano structures with this thing, they can go inside the nerves with the blood, taking all the information and sending it out. It's a kind of biomimicking only. That means that is already biorobotics. Because now electronic robotics are, because you have to give the instructions. But these bio, they are taking the instructions on their own. That means you do not have to give it. It's a good, you know, field, but long way to go or to realize.
Thank you very much for that, sir. I now request Professor Gopalkrishna Hegde to accept a small token of gratitude from Sahyadri family. To do the honors, I request our beloved HOD, Dr. Ashwath Rao, Department of Electronics and Communication, to hand over the memento. I also thank all the audience gathered here. With this, we are concluding today's morning session and also the Sahyadri Conclave's final session. Thank you, one and all. I am Sharachan.